Welcome dear students, in this presentation we will be learning geography lesson number 3, physiography and drainage module 3. Module 3 is based on drainage system in India. Lesson number 3, physiography and drainage in module 1, and in module 2 we have studied about physiographic division of India. Let's recap. We all know that India is the 7th largest country in the world. The country is bounded by the Great Himalayas in the north and Indian Ocean in the south. The southern part is flanked by the Bay of Bengal on the east and the Arabian Sea to the west of India. India has a very diversified physiographic conditions. The Indian subcontinent is characterized by a great and diversified group of physical features. They classified into physiographic division of India, such as the Himalaya, the North Indian Plain, the Peninsula, the Coastal Plain, and the Island Groups. Lesson number 3, Physiography and Drainage, Module 3. We will concentrate on what is drainage, how does the drainage system works in India on a such a large scale, division of drainage in India. They are Himalayan drainage and peninsular rivers. First of all, let us understand the meaning of drainage. The word drainage describes the river system in a particular area. The drainage system consists of total area covered by tributary. So tributary is a small river that flows into a larger river. So here the tributary and the other water body join in the main river. The place where rivers begin its journey is called its sources. Drainage system is also known as river system. So this system are the pattern formed by the streams and lakes. Let us understand the meaning of streams and lake. As you all know that streams is a small river, whereas lake is a large area of water that is surrounded by land. Sources of rivers. Some of the rivers flow naturally, whereas some of the rivers flow only in a rainy season. Major rivers in the Himalayas originate from the glaciers, also known as snow. In summer, when the glaciers melt, the rivers start flowing. You may know that a river is a natural flowing water course, usually fresh water flowing towards an ocean, sea, lake or another river. The drainage system in India are classified into the Himalayan drainage system and the peninsular drainage system. The Himalayan drainage system includes the river Ganga, the river Indus and the river Brahmaputra basin, whereas the peninsular rivers also divided into east flowing rivers and the west flowing rivers. The rivers such as Narmada, Tapi, Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna and Kaveri river. So student, where do all the rivers emerge from and where do they end? Have you ever thought of that? No? Let's learn. All the rivers in India form a river system which is known as the drainage system of India. Let's learn about the different rivers and the river system in India that together form the drainage system of our country. Himalayan drainage. Himalayan rivers are the rivers that originate from the snow-covered Himalayan ranges. These rivers are well fed by the rains during the rainy season. These rivers are also fed by the melting of the snow during summer season. Therefore, most of the Himalayan rivers are perennial in nature. Himalayan rivers. The Himalaya is the birthplace of many important rivers. The rivers of the Himalayas give a new dimension to the beautiful scenic beauty of the Himalayan region. The rivers are the main source of life in these areas. It helps in the formation of the forest belt and irrigation process in this region. The Himalayan river system originate in Himalayas and include the three main river system of India. They are River Indus, River Ganga, also known as River Ganges, and the River Brahmaputra. So these three river system, such as the Indus River, the Ganga River and the Brahmaputra River, not only include the rivers but also their tributaries. Let's take more information about River Indus. In Hindi and in Sanskrit, Indus River is also known as River Sindhu. The Indus River is a major river system in the Asia continent, which flows through Pakistan. Indus River originating in the Tibet or Tibetan Plateau near Lake Mansarovar. In Tibet, the Indus is known as the Lion's Mouth. It is the 21st largest river in the world in terms of annual flow. River Indus and tributaries. As you can see in the map, different arrows are indicating towards the river and its tributaries. So let's take more information about River Indus and its tributaries. The River Satluj, River Bias, River Ravi, River Chenab and the Jhelum River joins together to enter the Indus River near Mithankot in Pakistan. Beyond this, the Indus flow southward and enter into the Arabian Sea. In the plains, its tributary is River Chenab, which itself has four major tributaries, namely the River Jhelum, River Ravi, River Bias and the River Satluj. So these are the land of five rivers. The five rivers are River Chenab, River Jhelum, River Bias and River Satluj. All of these rivers which finally enter in the Indus River. The Indus River supports many heavy industries and provide the main supply of potable water in Pakistan. River Ganga originate from the Gangotri glaciers, also known as Gomukh, of western Himalayas in the Indian state of Uttarakhand, which is located in Uttar Pradesh, and flows south and east through the Ganga plain of India and Bangladesh, then enter into the Bay of Bengal. The Ganga or the Ganges is a lifeline to the millions of people who lived there. River Ganga passes through Kanpur, Allahabad and Varanasi. As you all know that in the earlier slides, we have studied that River Ganga originating from Gangotri glaciers at Gomukh covered a distance of 2,525 km before flowing into the Bay of Bengal. A large number of tributaries like Alaknanda, Ram Ganga, Kali, Yamuna, Gomati, Ghagra, Gandhak, Kosi and Son, all this draining 11 states of the country and then join River Ganga at the different points during its journey. Another major tributary of the Ganga flows through the northern part of the Greater Himalayas, crosses the Himalayas to enter India. So this river system is known as Brahmaputra. Let's take more information of River Brahmaputra. The Brahmaputra River is one of the major rivers of the Asia continent. It is a transboundary river. The Brahmaputra River is about 2,900 km long, originate from western Tibet as the Yarlung Tsangpo River. The river flows through three countries, born in Tibet, flowing through the India and then enter into Bangladesh. It has many names, Tsangpo in Tibet, Lohit
or Brahmaputra in India and Jamuna in Bangladesh.
As you all know that in the previous slides we have studied that Brahmaputra river system is one of the largest river in the world. Brahmaputra river originates in Tibet. When it crosses the Himalayas, it is called Dihang. In other words, it entered by the name of Dihang in India and its east flow known as River Brahmaputra. And after it is joined by the two main tributaries such as the Dibang and Lohit, it is known by the name of Brahmaputra. It flows in Bangladesh by the name of Jamuna River. Let's take information about peninsular rivers. The peninsular river system can be divided into east flowing rivers and the west flowing river. The rivers which flow in the east direction, they meet the Bay of Bengal, whereas the rivers which are west flowing, they enter into the Arabian Sea.
As we have studied in the previous slide that the peninsular river system further divided into east flowing river and the west flowing rivers. So we know that the east flowing rivers enter into Bay of Bengal and west flowing rivers enter into the Arabian Sea. Now let's see the which are the rivers, west flowing rivers and the east flowing rivers with the help of the map of India river map. The west flowing rivers are River Narmada, River Tapi, River Mahi, River Sabarmati and River Luni, whereas east flowing rivers are River Mahanadi, River Godavari, River Krishna and River Kaveri. Most of the peninsular rivers flow eastward on the plateau slope and enter into the Bay of Bengal. Here we have the east flowing rivers. So the east flowing rivers are River Mahanadi, River Godavari, River Krishna and River Kaveri. Let's see once again east flowing rivers with the help of the map. As you can see here, different arrows are indicating rivers. So east flowing rivers are River Mahanadi, River Godavari, River Krishna and River Kaveri. So this east flowing rivers originate from the western ghats and flow eastward and enter in the Bay of Bengal. The east flowing rivers are both perennial as well as seasonal rivers. The east flowing rivers are perennial river, those who originate from the Himalayas such as River Ganga, also known as River Ganges, River Yamuna and River Brahmaputra, whereas seasonal rivers, those who originate from the western ghats and other places such as River Mahanadi, River Godavari, River Krishna. So these rivers make delta at their mouth and fall into the Bay of Bengal. East flowing rivers are very longest river. Let's see the west flowing rivers. The west flowing rivers are River Narmada, River Tapi, River Mahi, River Sabarmati and River Luni. Let's take more information about west flowing river with the help of the map. West flowing rivers are River Narmada, River Tapi, River Mahi, River Sabarmati and River Luni. So these rivers originate in the central India and flow westward and enter into the Arabian Sea. West flowing rivers are shorter in nature. West flowing rivers such as River Narmada, River Tapi and River Sabarmati are seasonal rivers as they fade by rain.
Rivers meeting the Bay of Bengal. Most of the areas of the peninsula is drained by the rivers flowing towards the Bay of Bengal. The important river system of these groups are River Mahanadi, River Godavari, River Krishna and River Kaveri.
Let's take more information about rivers meeting the Bay of Bengal. As you can see here, the various arrows are indicating the rivers in India as well as the states. Let's see what they are. River Godavari is the second largest river system of India in terms of the catchment area. So, catchment area means the area from which rain flow into a river or the lake. To the south of the Godavari is located the basin of River Krishna. Its major tributary are River Bhima and River Tungabhadra. Then we have River Kaveri. River Kaveri basin flow through the state of Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. It is one of the major river of peninsula region. It is a river that has been harnessed for the irrigation since a long time. Till now we have studied the rivers of India. Let's see the importance of rivers in India. As you all know that the rivers of India play an important role in the lives of the people. They provide potable water, cheap transportation, electricity and the livelihood for many people nationwide. Rivers carry water and nutrients to the areas all around the earth's surface. They play a very important role in the water cycle, acting as a drainage system for surface water. Rivers drain nearly 75% of the earth's surface. Rivers provide excellent habitat and food for the many of the earth organisms. River pollution in India. The largest source of water pollution in India is untreated sewage. Other sources of pollution include agricultural and small-scale industry. Most of the rivers, lake and surface water in India are polluted due to various industries, untreated sewage and the solid waste. Various measures are taken to control the river pollution. Let's see what are the measures taken to control the river pollution in India. Displaying the hoarding information near the tourist not to pollute the water of the river, and also we can highlight the importance of cleanliness. Then removing solid waste from the rivers and applying other river cleanliness process. Also we can control the discharge of human sewage into the river. Also using sufficient and appropriate treatment to the industrial waste before entering into the rivers. Let's recap. So student, so far we have studied that the term drainage system. The term drainage system describes the river system of an area. A river is a natural flowing water. Drainage in India include the Himalayan drainage and peninsular rivers. In Himalayan drainage system, we have studied that most of the major rivers in Himalayas originate from the glaciers. It includes the rivers such as River Ganga, River Indus, also known as River Sindhu, and River Brahmaputra. So, all these three rivers are perennial in nature. In peninsular river system, we have studied that peninsular river system divide into east flowing rivers and west flowing rivers. East flowing rivers meeting the Bay of Bengal, whereas west flowing rivers meet the Arabian Sea. Also, we have studied the rivers meeting the Bay of Bengal. The rivers meeting the Bay of Bengal are River Mahanadi, River Godavari, River Krishna, River Kaveri. So, River Kaveri is the second largest river system of India in terms of catchment areas. Also, we have studied about river pollution and various measures taken to control river pollution.